Can you hear that? That is the sound of 40,000 fans screaming for their team in NRL finals week, and they'll be doing it in stadiums instead of lounge rooms. That's right, with restrictions now relaxed. Australian Rugby League Chairman Peter Volandis joins us now with the latest. Peter, good morning to you. This is great news.
Good morning, Alex. Fantastic news. The news that all the footy fans have been waiting for, and I compliment the New South Wales government, and particular Kerry Chant, the Chief Medical Officer. She's been the superstar in this whole COVID in New South Wales. She takes a balanced, measured view, does risk analysis, doesn't act on emotion, doesn't act on hyperbole. She's just been a fantastic person for New South Wales.
Yeah. Hey, we haven't seen crowds like this in a long time, before March. But I guess the question fans will be asking is, how will they be COVID safe at these grounds?
Look, it's always based on the data, Alex, and a risk analysis. At the moment in New South Wales, the community infection is next to zero and it's all been traced, so they all know the source. The government nevertheless has introduced protocols with face masks, which will be mandatory. You know, the seats will be checkered. You'll be able to enter and leave in different exits. Look, there's all these different protocols which will make it safe. But as I say, it's based on data, and the data at the moment shows that the community infections are low. And by the time the finals come, hopefully they'll be zero. So the risk is minimal.
If they are zero, does that mean more fans?
It could do, and I will monitor it and speak to government, because if there is no risk whatsoever, there could be more fans, because a lot of fans will miss out, and we want to, you know, accommodate as many fans as possible. They've been so loyal to the game. They've, you know, they've been season ticket holders and haven't asked for refunds, and members, and so we want to repay that loyalty, because our fans are our number one priority.
Yeah. The big question is, Peter, can we get a beer and a pie at the footy? I know at the Gabba they're still not sure whether that's going to be able to happen with the COVID guidelines. Will we be able to get a beer and a pie at the grand final?
Very important.
Very important.
Well, it's not a footy game without a beer and a pie.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
There'll be more pies in Sydney than ever, and
yes.
More. Oh, I shouldn't say too much beer. I don't want to get in any trouble, but
yes.
Certainly light beer.
Light beer, mid-strength beer.
Yeah.
Any sympathy for AFL, Peter? Especially that it's not at the MCG; it's up in Brisbane, whereas the Sydney, the grand final, is in Sydney this year. Any sympathy for our AFL cousins?
Zero. On that subject, while they're in Brisbane, it's like the people going to an ABBA concert when they're AC/DC fans. So they'll like the rhythm for a while, but they'll go back to the, you know, the real heavy stuff, the rugby league.
Oh, Peter. Oh, I was worried about that question, but you delivered, as always. Hey, but Peter, we've got to get to something a little bit more serious, and that is a former AFL player, Sean Smith. He's won a $1.4 million insurance payout due to concussions over the course of his career. Front page of the Herald Sun this morning. This is a problem that's not going away, is it?
No, it's not going away, and I don't know Sean's circumstances or his case, but I know in rugby league we've been proactive. We spend over $1 million a year on surveillance and research, and there's been, you know, introduction of different standards in junior football where, you know, it'll minimise knocks to the head. So we're taking it very seriously, and as I said, we invest over $1 million a year, and we've also, in a partnership with Harvard University on concussion, we're doing everything we possibly can, and I'm very confident in the actions that the NRL have taken.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, also, it's Women in League round this week. That's a big round.
Magnificent round, and I should say that we're the only code that's kept our women's rugby league going. You know, our elite competition starts, and I can't see that great AFL women's league. Where's that this year? But we certainly take women's rugby league very seriously, and we look forward to the games. And you know, look, we just love the women's game, and it's our fastest growing participation. So you know, even women now realise how great the game it is.
Yeah, yeah. I take it you won't be watching the AFL grand final, Peter.
No, I'll be at the races, Alex. So I'll probably miss it.
Fair enough. Hey, well done, you.
I'm an AC/DC fan.
You are an AC/DC fan.
Unbelievable.
Hey, Peter, you've done so much work on this.
I sometimes do listen to ABBA.
Good. Of course you do. I picked you for an ABBA man. Well done, you. You've done so much work on this. And, hey, fans at the footy, how good?